Hello students, this is our sixth session of chapter 2, Input-Output Memory Devices. In the last sessions, we have discussed like what is primary memory and the types of primary memory. In this session, we are discussing about secondary storage devices. So why do we need secondary storage devices? Since the storage capacity of the primary memory is not very large, which cannot hold data including the programs which are needed for processing, thus the secondary memory is necessary. It is slow compared to the primary memory and it is used as auxiliary memory This means that the information which is not currently processed are stored in secondary storage devices. The information which is required for the CPU for current processing is transferred from the secondary storage devices to the main memory. And it is used for bulk storage of data and other information. And it has larger capacity than the main memory. And it stores system software, compiler, assemblers and useful packages, etc. And it should not be of volatile nature. It should store the data permanently. Now let's see what is hard disk. So hard disk is a magnetic disk on which you can store computer data. So it's a direct access storage medium. This means that you can store the data and retrieve data randomly. And it has a high speed rotating surfaces coated with magnetic recording medium. And it rotates the speed of 7000 rotation per minute. So the modern hard disk can hold up to 40 to 200 GB of data. And you can perform read and write operations on hard disk. Each circular disk is divided into tracks and sectors. So each track is divided into number of sectors. So each sector is holding specific number of data elements. The smallest unit on which you can perform read or write operations on a disk is called as sector. The arrangement of tracks and sectors on the disk is called as format. And the storage capacity of the disk can be calculated using the formula, that is number of tracks into number of sectors into number of bytes per sector into number of read or write heads. Next is floppy disk. What is floppy disk? Floppy disk contains a single flat piece of circular plastic coated with metal oxide and enclosed in a vinyl. And these diskettes are small and portable. Because of the size of the floppy disk is small, they are portable. Portable means we can carry anywhere. The three common sizes of the disks are 3.5 inches, 5 1/4 inches and 8 inches in diameter. But the most commonly used size is 3.5 inches, which can hold up to 1.44 MB of data, and it is cheaper than any other storage medium. So what is secondary storage devices? So what is the necessity of secondary storage device? Since the storage capacity of the primary memory is not large, to store the data as well as the programs which is required for processing, we need secondary storage devices, and they are small and they are slow compared to the primary memory, and it is used as auxiliary memory. What is the meaning of auxiliary memory? The information which is not currently processed are stored in the secondary storage devices. The information which is needed for the CPU for current processing is transferred from secondary storage devices to the main memory, and it is used for bulk storage of data and other informations, and it has larger capacity. It stores system software, compilers, assemblers and useful packages, and it should not be of volatile nature. It should store the data permanently. When it comes to hard disk, it's a magnetic disk where you can store the computer data, and it's a direct access storage medium. It contains high speed rotating surfaces coated with magnetic recording medium. It rotates at a speed of 7200 rotation per minute, and it holds 40 to 200 GB of data, and you can perform read and write operation. So each circular disk is divided into tracks and sectors. So each track is subdivided into sectors where it can store a specific number of data elements. So the storage capacity can be calculated using the formula: number of tracks into number of sectors into number of bytes per sector into number of read or write heads. When it comes to floppy disk, it contains a single flat piece of circular plastic coated with metal oxide and enclosed in a vinyl, and it is small and portable. The three common sizes are 3.5 inches, 5 1 by 4 inches and 8 inches, but the most commonly used size is 3.5 inches, which can store up to 1.44 MB of data, and it is cheaper than any other storage devices. Next is optical disk. What is optical disk? They are the storage medium from which data is read and to which it is returned by the laser. So the data is read and to which it is returned by the laser, and they are random access storage medium. They are random access storage medium, which means that we can access the data randomly, or we can access the data from any point on the disk. There are different types of optical laser devices. The first one is CD-ROM, second one is DVD, and third one is Blu-ray disc. And third one is Blu-ray disc. What is CD-ROM? So CD-ROM refers to compact disc read-only memory. It is referred as compact disc read-only memory. So it is read-only optical storage medium. It is read-only optical storage medium with the storage capacity of 682 MB of data. With the storage capacity of 682 MB of data, and accessing of data in CD-ROM is faster than the floppy disk and slower than the hard disk. So you can access the data very fast, a bit faster when compared to floppy disk, and it is slower than the hard disk. And to read the data from the CD-ROM, we require CD-ROM drive. So here there are two types of CD-ROM. First one is CD-R and second one is CD-RW. So CD-R is also referred as compact disc readable. Compact disc readable. And CD-RW is also referred as compact disc rewritable. Compact disc rewritable. Compact disc rewritable. So next is DVD. What is DVD? DVD stands for digital versatile disc. DVD stands for digital versatile disc, and it's an optical disc technology with 4.7 GB storage capacity. It's a optical disc technology with 4.7 GB storage of data. So here we can not only store the videos, but we can also store music and other forms of data. The two types of DVD are DVD-R and DVD-RW. So DVD-R is also referred as digital versatile disc readable. Digital versatile disc readable, and DVD-RW is also referred as digital versatile disc rewritable. Digital versatile disc rewritable. Rewritable. So what is Blu-ray disc? Blu-ray disc is another type of optical laser devices. So Blu-ray disc is also referred as BD. It is also referred as BD. The name Blu-ray disc is obtained from blue-violet color laser. Blue-violet color laser, which is used to read the stored data on the disc. And it has the high capacity storage technology with 25 GB to 50 GB of data we can store here. So what is optical disc? Optical disc is a storage medium from which data is read and to which it is written using the laser, and it is also called as random access storage medium, which means that we can access the data randomly at any point of disk. So there are three types of optical laser devices, that is CD-ROM, DVD and Blu-ray disc. CD-ROM stands for compact disc read only memory, and it is a read only storage medium with a capacity of 682 MB. So here we can access the data a bit faster than the floppy disk and slower than the hard disk. So CD drive is needed to read the CD-ROM. So there are two types of CD-ROM, that is CD-R and CD-RW. That is, CD-R is referred as compact disc readable, and CD-RW is referred as compact disc rewritable. When it comes to DVD, DVD stands for digital versatile disc. It's an optical disc technology with storage capacity of 4.7 GB of data, and it is also used to store music and other forms of data. There are two types of DVD, DVD-R and DVD-RW. When it comes to Blu-ray disc, it is also referred as BD. So the name Blu-ray comes from blue-violet color laser, which is used to read the stored data on the Blu-ray disc. It has a high capacity storage medium, that is, we can store 25 GB to 50 GB of data. So this is about the optical disc and the types of optical laser devices. Next is portable storage devices. So the next is portable storage devices. So portable storage devices is also referred as PSD. It is also referred as PSD. It is designed to hold any kind of digital data. It is designed to hold any kind of digital data. The word portable refers to which we can carry the devices anywhere. And it is different from other portable media player, which stores and play music as well as movies. The fixed size hard drives are of 256 GB, 320 GB, 500 GB and 1 TB. So this is about portable storage devices. The word portable means we can carry the devices anywhere. And it is designed to hold any kind of digital data. And it is different from a portable media player which stores and play music and movies. Some of the fixed size are 256 GB, 320 GB, 500 GB and 1 TB. When it comes to cache memory, what is cache memory? The cache memory resides between the CPU and the main memory. It resides between CPU and the main memory. It is much faster. It is much faster than main memory. It is much faster than main memory. It holds the most recent data and instructions. It holds most recent data. Most recent data or instructions. Cache memory is used to minimize the average access reading time in the main memory. So hence this cache memory increases the operating speed of the system. It increases the operating speed of the system. And it is much costlier than other storage devices. It is much costlier than any other storage devices. So in cache memory, there are two levels, that is L1 cache and L2 cache. L1 cache and L2 cache. L1 cache is present inside the CPU. It is present inside the CPU. Inside the CPU. And L2 cache is present on the motherboard, which is present on the motherboard, is called as L2 level cache. So cache memory is present between the CPU and the main memory, and it is much faster than the main memory. It holds the most recent data or instructions. So it minimizes the average access reading time as they stored in the main memory. It increases the operating speed of the system and it is much costlier than main memory. So there are two levels of cache, that is L1 cache and L2 cache. L1 cache, which is present inside the CPU, and L2 cache is present on the motherboard, is called as L2 cache. So this completes this chapter. So you can easily score 6 marks from this chapter, that is input-output memory devices. In the next session, I will come with a new chapter called data representation. Thank you.